So last week at Adobe Max London, we announced updates to Lightroom and Adobe Camera Raw. In my previous video that I'll link to at the end of this one, I shared the new features and improvements that were added to Lightroom Desktop version 8.3. In this video, though, I'm going to focus on what's new for Lightroom Mobile 10.3 for iOS. Now, one of the things that I'm really excited about with this video is that it'll be the first time that I get to share a new feature that was added to Lightroom Mobile for Android. In fact, I covered this feature a while ago for Lightroom Mobile on the iPhone and iPad, and we've gotten tons of feedback from Android users that they'd also love to have this feature too. Of course, I'm referring to the ability to add a border to your photo during export, which is now available for Lightroom Mobile Android users. And I'd like to start by showing that to you right now, followed by all the improvements to sharing and portrait retouching using quick actions for Lightroom Mobile for iOS. All right, let's dive in. All right, so I'm very excited because I do finally get to show you a feature that Lightroom Android users have been asking for a very long time. So this is a Samsung Galaxy S25 Ultra. I'm going to start by tapping on Lightroom to launch it. And you can see I've got this photo here of a bird. Now, super quickly, I'm just going to apply a super quick edit. I'm going to go to profiles here and I'm going to apply adaptive color. That looks great over here. And then of course, I'm going to apply a very, very slight S curve just to give it a bit of contrast. You know me, I need my S curves even on Android devices. Now, the other thing that I want to do is I actually want to export this as a square for Instagram. So I'm going to go to crop over here and I'm going to tap on aspects and then I'm going to tap on one by one, which is square. And then you can position this however you see fit. So I'm going to tap on done and then tap on the check mark. Now, there are two ways that you can add a border, but both of them will start with you tapping on the share icon on the top right. The first is you see that share menu item. But you don't want to just tap that. The first thing you'll want to do is tap on the gear to the right of that. And you'll see there is include border. So I'm going to enable that. And then I'm going to tap on customize. And so here you can see we've got our border. And we have different colors that you can choose from. You could just tap on whichever one you want. But I actually want white. I always find pretty much anytime I'm adding a border, it's either going to be white or black. But white almost all the time. Then there's a thickness slider, and this is going to adjust the size of the image. So if you want a really chunky border, you can. So, you know, generally I do like that. Usually I keep it around 20. And then of course, if you wanted to change the border size, let's say you were going to publish this as a 2x3 or a 4x5 for a vertical Instagram post, you can do that. But like I said, I'm going to stick with the original, and really that's all I need to do. I can tap on the back button over here. I'll tap on it again, and then I'm gonna tap on share, and then choose the destination that you wanna share it to. The other way that you can do this is if you tap on share again and tap on export as, you have a bit more control here, and you also see over here, there is the include border option with the same customize options. So if you want, again, you can choose the color, the thickness, and the actual border size. And then when you go back over here, you can tap on the check mark on the top right to select where you want to share it to. All right, so there you go. This, like I said, was a feature that Lightroom Mobile Android users have been asking for a while. And so it just feels great to deliver on that. And I hope that Android users enjoy it and get the most out of being able to add a border on export. Now I want to switch gears to Lightroom Mobile for my iPhone. So this is Lightroom Mobile 10.3. And the iPhone that I'm using is the iPhone 16 Pro Max. There are two key areas where improvements will be very quickly apparent to our users. The first has to do with the sharing experience. And I wanna show you why I think sharing using Lightroom on mobile devices is an amazing option, especially when you are gonna be going to an event, like a birthday party or just any party or a wedding. And then there's also a really great improvement to the portrait retouching functionality of quick action. So I'm going to show you both of those right now. Okay, so like I said, this is my iPhone 16 Pro Max, and this is a Lightroom Mobile 10.3. Now, this looks like an awesome party, right? Like just really cool photos. Truth be told, I have no idea who any of these people are. Truth be told, also, I just haven't been to this kind of a really raging party in a very long time. So I found these on a stock website. Still, it gives me an opportunity to illustrate to you a few of the things that I want to tell you about with sharing. So watch, if I tap and hold to enter multi-select, I'm going to tap on these three images, and then I'm going to tap on share on the bottom. Here's what's new. You can see this carousel view, which makes it really easy. Like, let's say I also want to add this one. I can. And then I can use these different sharing options, like tapping on share to bring up the share screen, or export as, which allows me to choose different options like the file format. Another really cool thing is at the very bottom, you see there's the ability to share on web. So what will happen is we will create an ad hoc web gallery with those four images that were selected, and you can share them with whoever you want. But I'm going to walk you through this because there's another option that we added that I think is so cool. So check this out. I'm going to cancel out of here, and I'm going to exit out of multi-image select mode. Now, again, let's pretend I was at this party and I took all of these fun photos with my friends. And it's safe to assume that other people at this party took photos. So what if I can create an album where everyone can contribute their photos and access the photos that everyone else shares? That's what's so cool. What I'm going to do is I'm going to tap on the album share button on the top over here. And that's going to bring us to the share screen. Now, I want this to be open to everybody. So I'm going to tap on the back button over here. And the first thing I'm going to do is tap on get shareable link. So that creates the share, and you can see how it also sets it to public, which means anyone can view. Now, one of the first improvements in terms of the album sharing experience that you now have access to is you see to the left of the copy button, there's a little QR code icon. If I tap on this, we create this beautiful looking QR code card. You can download this to your camera roll, you can share it to anybody, or you can just hold it up so that another person can use their mobile phone's camera to load the album. Now, the other thing that you can do from here is enable this option, which I want to show you, called anyone can add photos. I'm going to turn that on, and then I'm going to close out of here. That switch also corresponds right here. You can see anyone can add photos. This is what you want to turn on. This makes it so much easier for anyone basically to contribute to your album. Now, before I do that, I'm going to go to customize title and template. I'm going to change the appearance to light. And over here in the title, I'm just going to get rid of that number one. So it just says improved sharing experience. I can tap back here. You can see how it updates on the fly. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to tap on copy so that I can copy the URL to my clipboard, and I'm going to switch over to my Mac. And so what I want to do is I want to simulate what it's like to be the recipient of that URL that I copied. So let's pretend I'm a friend, another person who went to the party, and I just received that URL that was copied. So if I go to my computer here and I paste that URL, now remember, I can either paste it in the desktop, or I could have used the QR code from my friend's phone. But when I go to the album over here, you can see here are all of the photos. Now, in order for me to contribute to someone else's shared album, I do need to have an Adobe ID, which is free. If you don't have one, you can go to adobe.com and create one for free. But you do need to be logged in, because if you think about it, you don't want just anybody contributing anything to that album. So by having that account, it just makes things a little bit more protected for you. And then once you are logged in, you can see there will be an icon up here called Add Photos. Now, on my desktop, I just have a few extra photos from that epic party. So what I'll do is I'm going to click Add Photos, and I'm just going to select these five photos and drop them right over here. Once that's done, I'll click on Upload Five Photos. Now, you have the option, if the photos have location data, to include that. You just need to switch that on and then just click on Upload Five Photos again. And when they're done, you just click on close and refresh. And now here's something I want to show you. So this right here, in each of the thumbnails on the bottom right, there will be a little kind of avatar. And so this is the avatar of my primary Adobe account. This here, this is kind of my test account. You can see my avatar that I set for that. It's intentionally different. And you can also see right here that it shows who uploaded which photos. So as more people start adding photos to this shared album, you'll see their little avatars on the bottom right of each of the thumbnails, which I think is awesome. Of course, you can click in through here. You can click on the info button to get more info, and it'll show you who added the image. And another cool thing is that if I go back to my iPhone, you can see to the right of the roll for the album where it says public, anyone can view, I can click on the gear icon here and I can enable the option for JPEG downloads. I'll tap on back over here and tap on the check mark. And now on my desktop, when I refresh, you'll see there is that option here to download the JPEGs in this album so that if other people who are part of this album want to have copies of the photos for themselves, they will have them. And if I go back to my iPhone here, you'll see there are the images that were uploaded by my other account. So let's say I tap in here and I tap on the info button. Right there on the bottom, you'll see who added that photo, which was me, which I think is super awesome. And that's also kind of a really quick public service announcement where if you have an Adobe ID, go and log in at adobe.com and make sure that you specify your own kind of avatar image so that it makes it easier to identify that it's you who's uploaded photos to shared albums. But again, I think that this is such a cool experience. Like sharing photos using Lightroom has gotten amazing with the ability to share these really pretty QR code cards and the ability for multiple people to contribute. It's just like such an easy way to create this central location for everyone to collect their photos from an event. Okay, to wrap things up with the new features added to Lightroom Mobile for iOS, we're gonna look at these three images of portraits. Now, to be completely honest, I don't really take photos of people. So again, I found photos of other people from a stock website, but it'll allow me to illustrate this amazing new update to Quick Actions. So if you remember Quick Actions, you can access it by opening up an image and then tapping on the wand on the very bottom left toolbar. What Quick Actions will do is it will analyze the contents of a photo and it'll surface recommended edits to apply. So you can see that there's a sky, so it's recommending some sky edits, as well as the ability to edit the background, subjects, and retouch. Retouch is going to be available when Lightroom identifies that there are people, at least one person in the photo. And this is what's awesome. So you can see I have a photo here with five people. This has six people, and this image has seven people. Now, before, when you used the retouch option in Quick Actions, it will let you edit things like the eyes, but it would basically edit the entire image, so all of the eyes and image. Now, if I go into this photo here and I tap on retouch, you'll see that Lightroom will create little thumbnails for each individual person. So as I tap through here, it zooms in on the person and it gives options for certain attributes to edit. So here, let's say I go to teeth, I can whiten the teeth, I can say add a bit of skin smoothing, and I can add a bit more detail to the hair. And then as I tap through here, I can make unique edits to each individual person. So maybe here I want to make the clothing a bit more enhanced and then just really quickly move on, like make the eyes brighter, teeth a little whiter, move on to the fourth person here. Again, let's enhance the clothing, let's smooth the skin. And then finally here, again, let's make the eyes pop a bit. We'll smooth the skin. Let's bring out detail in the clothing. And you notice how when you go to clothing, it zooms out a bit so you can see here. I'm actually going to hide the histogram, but you can see the entire person. But when I start editing the face, it zooms tighter, which I think is amazing. So I'm going to tap over here. And so we've made those edits. And the reason why I have these other images is because I want to illustrate, like that was five people. If I tap on retouch here, you can see there are six different thumbnails. And as I tap through them, it zooms to that individual person. And it allows you to make refined edits for each person, which is really powerful because before, if you made edits, it would apply to everybody in the image. But I've got one more photo with seven people. Again, just to illustrate here that, I mean, it really is impressive. Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And one thing, again, that I want to highlight is that the attributes that are surfaced are relevant to the individual. So here, you see how we don't have the ability to whiten teeth. But if I tap on this person, because the teeth are visible, I can whiten their teeth. And so it's that kind of like, even though it's one-click editing, it's refined one-click editing. Like, it's specific to the image and now to the individual subjects that you're editing within that image. Now, we announced Quick Actions last October at Adobe Max in Miami, and it really is great to see that it's getting even more and more powerful because, listen, even if you are a Power Lightroom user, like for me, I love that I can make these edits, these powerful edits, edits that I'd actually want to make for, say, a portrait photo, but I don't have to do it to everybody using the same settings. Now I can just click through and apply individualized edits to each person that's detected. And I think that is so powerful. Now, again, this is an update for Lightroom Mobile, but if you want to learn everything there is to know about Lightroom desktop, mobile, and web, then please do check out my course called Lightroom Everywhere. I'll leave a link to it in the description below. And I mentioned at the beginning of this video that I have another video that walks through all of the new updates to Lightroom desktop version 8.3. Check that out. Now, if you found this video helpful, please click on the thumbs up button. It really does help the channel. And be sure to click on subscribe and the bell icon to get notified of all future videos. Thanks a lot, everyone.